So today we're extracting and sowing willow seed, as it's one of the trickier ones to do because there are a few stages to it. And our first one is extracting the seed. So after you've been out and you've collected your catkins, that's general time for collecting these, sort of late May until the middle of June. So bring your catkins back inside, let them dry off, either wrap them in newspaper, have them beside a wee heater or something. And then once they're nice and dry, pop them into a box like this. Then get that box into a bit of heat, and then once it heats up, the catkins then dehiss, and then all the fluff and then the seed is on show. And our next stage in the process is getting the hoover out and sifting out the seed from all the leaves and the debris. We've removed the bag from the hoover, we've put the filter back on. Close that one back up. As I say, we'll get another wee hoover through that. If we keep that in the heat for another sort of 3 to 4 days, it'll be worth rechecking that one. And then we should have our seeds all in the bottom of the bucket here. Carefully remove the top of your hoover. And there's our seed at the bottom there. Once we've got our seed extracted, we want to mix it with the sand here. So first thing, pop around a cup of kiln-dried sand into your large container here. You get your seed that you've already extracted. I like to use about a cup per 1 gram of seed there. And then we want to spend the next, you really want sort of a couple of minutes of just going back and forth between the two containers just to get the seed and sand nicely evenly split. And that's us starting to get that nicely spread out. You see a good mixture of the little specks of green seed. Right, so the next thing we want to do is to soak our trays up before we broadcast our seed over it. So just, if your lands, just absolutely saturate your trays. You don't want to be watering these seed trays in the first couple of days with the seed being so fine. If you come and try and water it, you could blast it all to the one side. So this way, we're sowing the seed onto a nice saturated tray. As soon as the seed hits the moisture, it just starts soaking it all up. And then that will just start the germination process. For our 1 gram of seed, we're doing about 1 meter squared worth of trays. So we should get around 3,500 seedlings out of that 1 gram. So that gives us around 600 plants per tray, which is a nice sort of stocking density. That should be us about there. And there, you can even just hear it, that it's ready to go. Before you start sowing it over the trays directly, if it's your first time doing it, it's worth giving yourself a wee sort of practice run. So just giving yourself a little handful like that, and it's over these fingers here that we want the seed to sort of fall out across. And just practice doing it into the tray a few times. I go around the side of the trays first, just so I know I get all the corners, and then I'll do the sort of main body of it. And the beauty of mixing it with the sand, not only do you get a good sort of distribution of your seed, you can actually see where you've been. And then as you've been round it a couple of times, you can start to see maybe some patches you've not quite got enough on. So that's all my edges done. So now it's a case of doing the main part of it. So you can actually get a little bit more in your hand this time. Wider movements, try and do the whole tray. You don't want to put too much in it. If your tray is just tightly packed, you're going to get a lot of small sort of dunted seedlings, whereas if you give it a bit more space, you'll get a nice sort of robust thick seedling out of it. To protect the seed from the sunlight, we put a UV cloth over it for the first couple of weeks. If you get some dull days once they're up and germinated, you can remove the sheet and just get it sort of acclimatised to the sunlight. After around 3 weeks in the greenhouse, you'll have something like this. The plants are up at a nice size. They're around sort of 3 to 4 centimetres. They've got a few different truss leaves on them. You're ready to then transplant them into their final growing cell. So I've made a wee dibbing device here just to create us the little pocket that the seedling will go into. And then this is the bit to be careful for. So certainly always choose your nice big ones and make sure you get a nice wee root ball on them. We want all those wee fibre roots all together. So really sort of dig right under it. And you want to be getting something like that. So there we go, that's a perfect example. Plenty of roots on it, so we know it's going to do well. And you're just popping it in, then firming around it just into place. And here we've got one. I've got one real nice one there and a small one. We could go through that splitting it so you can get the two plugs, but I think by the time you do that, you can really damage the smaller one. And willow does quite well as a sort of a shrubby species, so you can just pop it in with the doubles. A little bit of your grown medium around the top, just keeping your leaves out of the soil itself. So after we've transplanted them, they're still quite delicate for a couple of weeks, so they'll need a good bit of water sort of every day for the next sort of week or so. And then they'd like a couple of weeks in the greenhouse just to firm themselves in, and then that's when you can pop them outside. We've got one full year of growth, and then this is what you'll be left with. And then that's ready for getting out to the planting site and getting them out in the ground.